morning. A few more words, just to introduce, because most of you are probably not Greek Orthodox Christian. So Mary Ray was a Greek Orthodox Christian, so that's the service that they will do. It's a standard service that has been of a century. It'd be familiar to you in some ways as Christians, but somehow it's slightly different. So let me give you an example. The ancient Christians would use Psalm 118. If you know about Psalm, it's the longest one of all the Psalms. That was used for a certain reason, very, very interestingly, for a time when we married Christians. Because it was all about faithfulness to the commandments of God. And being joyful and delighted to have these rules of life that would bring us to a kingdom and bring us to eternity and everlasting life. And so it may not at first see the connection between, you know, my soul rejoices in receiving commandments of God. Modern mind sees rules as valid. But we would see rules as a way of having a good life. And so therefore, when we have the mind of God, we also have then a way of living and a way of course, believing the promises that he has given us. So that's just one example. And you'll find other things that we're going to do, the attitudes that we'll say, about those who are blessed. And so this is how we're going to pray. And we also say, you know, this is a time for praising God, even though we are sad. But we praise God with great love for us. Okay? So please rise.
Blessed is God always, now and ever, in the ages of ages. Amen. Amen. Alleluia. Blessed are the undefiled. Alleluia. Alleluia. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your rules of life. Alleluia. My soul is now burning with a desire to obey your truth. Alleluia. My soul has grown weary. See, strengthen me with your words of life. Alleluia. Lead me in my faithfulness to your testimonies, and ever and on unto my self-centeredness. Alleluia. I have been exceedingly distressed because of unjust man who disregard your law. Alleluia. I am a true companion of all love and fear you, and keep and honor your commandments. Alleluia. Your own hand created me and fashioned me. Give me understanding that I may learn your commandments. Be merciful to me, O Lord. Even though I have shriveled like a wineskin in the dew of abandon, I have not forgotten your rules of life. Be merciful to me, O Lord. I am yours, save me. For your commandments I sought in life. Be merciful to me, O Lord. From all of your instructions, O Lord, and I have never strayed. For you have given me the law. Be merciful to me, O Lord. I have inclined my heart to follow your commandments and find my true reward. Be merciful to me, O Lord. My Lord, a time for you to justice, grant me life, alleluia. When once unjustly persecuted me, when my heart has been in pain of your words, let my soul live, and it shall praise you, and your ordinances shall assist me. I wandered as a sheep who lost the trodden path, but I come back, O Lord, because of your commandments. In logito sirie dilaxon et adio vatasasu. Sona io no caros evdigintis ois ceretiran paradis. Dounias and Dounias, to Apollos, Proaton ego enian caleseme, sotir pisos orbe. Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your commandments. Of all you created me out of nothing, with your divine image, but from likeness again restore me to that ancient beauty, I pray return to me. Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your commandments. I am an icon of your ineffable glory, even though I bear marks of sin upon me. Take pity, Lord, on your creation, and cleanse me in your compassion. My cherished homeland do you grant to me, make me a citizen of the paradise. Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your commandments. Give rest, O God, to a departed servant, and place her in paradise. Where, O Lord, the choirs of the saints and of the righteous shine as the stars of heaven. Give your servant an eternal rest, overlooking all their trespasses. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. The triple splendor of your Godhead and His divinity, let us gratefully, reverently chanting, Holy are you, eternal Father, co-eternal Son, and in spirit divine, shine on us who in faith worship you, and in the rush of fire eternal, now and ever into the ages of ages, amen. Hail, Holy One who bore God in the flesh, so that all of us could be saved. Through you, the human race has found salvation.
desires the angels leading me. Therefore, my beloved brother, realizing the shortness of life, let us ask of Christ to rest in the pardon and bustle of his great mercies. Many things are human vanity, we should not survive a person's death. Riches do not go with us, for the true glory accompanies us on the way. When death comes, all of this vanishes, for we cry to Christ as his immortal King, the rescue of her who departed from us. And indeed, how awesome the mystery of death is. The soul is forcibly separated from its harmony, toning its union with the body. Although their coexistence is not a law and by divine will, divine will is broken. Therefore, we implore you to be arrested and to marry in the place of the righteous, or give her a life. Now, where is all the earthly activities and all the of our thoughts and plans? Where is the gold and silver? Where are the multitude of servants? Our dust and ashes are just as the screen. Let come, let us raise our voices to be a more king. O Lord, count us worthy of eternal joy. And Mary, who has come from us, grant you rest in the age of blessedness. The words of the prophet Ezekiel combined when he said, I was earth and dust, and again I looked into the graves and beheld naked bones. To whom could I belong? To a king or to a rich man or to a poor man? But you could give rest now to your servant, Lord, knowing just as gracious and God. Our origin, our very being, have come from your creative command. Grant your will, you fashioned man and woman, a living being, from invisible and visible nature. From the earth, our bodies were formed. You gave us a soul by your breath, the life-giving divine breath of God. So Christ, give you rest to the land of the living, to the soul Mary. In your very image, your likeness, in the beginning were we created. You have placed us in a paradise to rule over as stewards. But deceived by the devil, we tasted of the fruit and became violators of your own law. Therefore, condemn us to the earth from which we came, for now grant us your eternal rest. I weep and I lament when I come face to face with death, and I see lying in the waves of beauty, which was made in the image of God, now disfigured and glorious and all its form destroyed. How strange indeed that this lamentable mystery should happen unto us, how we gave in to corruption, made partners with death. Indeed, this was by the command of God. Glory be the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Your death, O Lord, for us be the cause of our salvation. For had you not the tomb been laid for us, paradise would not have opened up. Therefore, grant rest in your eternal love for man. Now and always, and in the ages of ages, amen. O pure Virgin, who the Word's holy gate, God's Mother, entreaty we ask that mercy be granted to her soul.
In thy kingdom remember us, O Lord, when you come into your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit.
epistle of Paul, the Thessalonians, brothers and sisters, I do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep, so that you will not grieve like those who have no hope. Because if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, we must believe that God will bring with him to all those who have died in the world. This is the Lord's teaching, my God. We will be the living, to survive until the coming. In no way need Christ ahead of those who fall asleep. The Lord himself will come down heaven with a sharp in that hand. The archangel's voice and the trumpet of God, and those who have died believing in Christ will rise first. Then we who are still alive being on the earth will be caught up with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air and to remain with him forever. A reading of the Gospel is taken from St. John of the Elohim. The Lord said to the Jews who came to him, when I tell you the truth, whoever hears my words and believes and sent me has everlasting life. Do not be judged as has already passed from dead to life. I tell you the truth, the time is coming. Already, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, those who hear it will live. Even as the Father is himself the source of life, in the same way he's made his Son to be the source of life. He's given the Son the right to judge because he's the Son of Man. Do not be surprised at this. Time is coming, all the dead and raised, and hear his voice will come forth. Those who have done good look to a resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to a resurrection of sin. I can do nothing of my own authority, I hear, I judge. My judgment is just. Because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the Father who sent me. We pray for the repose of the soul of Mary, who has fallen asleep, for the forgiveness of all her sins, voluntary and involuntary. May the Lord God place her soul with the righteous rest, and grant to her the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, forgiveness of sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King of God. O God, spirit and flesh, who has trampled down death, crushing the power of the devil, giving life to your world, give rest to your servant Mary, in a place of light, in a place of rest, that is neither sorrow nor pain. Forgive her sins. There is no one on earth that does not sin. You are the resurrection and repose. Mary, who has fallen asleep. Christ, our God, do we offer glory with your eternal Father and your Holy Spirit, now and ever to the ages of ages. Amen. May your memory be eternal, ever blessed, ever memorable sister. May your memory be eternal, ever blessed, memorable sister. May your memory be eternal, ever blessed, ever memorable sister.
Sprinkle me.